The Flourish Prizes are the first Nobel-level recognition for business innovation built on a global learning platform. The mission is to elevate business as a positive catalyst to change behavior and create a flourishing world for all. It will showcase inspiring and empowering businesses that are building a more hopeful future by recognizing the profit in solving the world's greatest challenges. And by doing so, we can move the world to the tipping point where business as an agent of world benefit become the norm.
Indonesia is a country rich of herbs and spices.
Spices and herbs are used as basic ingredients which used for various products such as incense, medicine, and cosmetics.
Mustika Ratu utilize these natural resources as competitive advantage. They have specialized plantation in Ciawi Bogor, West Java, to ensure supply of high-quality natural ingredients and performing product differentiation.
Mustika Ratu established in 1975, one of Indonesia's leading cosmetic and herb traditional product companies. It first established under the name of PT Mustika Ratu and has an excellent reputation and expertise in cosmetic and herb traditional. The company's operation by commercial distribution product to stores and partnership by agent starting began in 1978.
The vision of Mustika Ratu is making the traditional legacy of the ancestor family as a basis for the healthcare and holistic wellness beauty industry by a sustainable technology modernization process, yet in nature still relies on the natural plants. The mission of Mustika Ratu is as the philosophy of health and holistic wellness beauty, which has been abandoned since a long time by people, is redacted by a playlist princess as a royal heritage to be spread to the world as the God gift in the term of knowledge which shall be maintained and preserved.
Ms. Buryati Sudipyo, the world's only known self-made Nobel woman turned a successful entrepreneur. She was born in Solo on 5th of January 1928 and raised inside the Keraton. She is the founder of Mustika Ratu and set up a business homemade herbal health supplement called Jamu, a Japanese health care terminology for wellness and excellence. She has created more than 250 items of herbal supplement product and 300 items of natural cosmetic that are being merchandised over the country.
It's possible, as many as possible, yeah, because we are now looking for countries who are interested, of course, in such a product like we have, yeah, because we have indigenous derived from natural resources, as we have the biggest resources, environment, discuss environment, and we'll stop with all the supply of the raw material, because we also treat the farmers to supply the standard of raw material.
Our consideration at choosing PT Mustika Ratu Tbk as nominee because it met criteria for business as an agent of world benefit, such as a for-profit business, scalable to other regions, across all sectors society, including the bottom of the pyramid, has business model innovation, which are LPPMS and Yayasan Putri Indonesia, that are related its social concerns, such as their participation as PNN Ambassador, Ambassador of National Commission for Child Protection, Ambassador Committee on AIDS, and Environment Ambassador. PT Mustika Ratu business innovation is sustained and embedded also present evidence of radical innovation. And also, PT Mustika Ratu presents evidence of care for its employees in ways that enable them to bring their whole selves to work, a culture that supports individuals flourishing.
Raden Ajeng Kartini is held in Indonesia as the country's first feminist. She was born in April 21, 1879 in North Central Java, the daughter of a Japanese official serving the Dutch colonial government. During this time, women were excluded from the age of 14 until marriage. This did not stop Kartini from aspiring for higher education. She received a scholarship to study, but succumbed to family pressure not to continue her education.
Kartini founded a school for young girls. Kartini wrote passionately for the improvement of education, public health, economic welfare, and traditional arts in her country. Kartini argues that women should be educated because they are the mothers of the future nation's leader.
Kartini's view, given the resources and the Japanese population of 27 million, educational policy should first be directed to the elite women who could then open schools for the rest of the masses.
The new era of Kartini has born in 1977 as LPPMS founded by Muriati Subio. She teach science, traditional beauty to beauty experts.
In 2003, she confirmed the name of Lembaga Pendidikan dan Pelatihan Muriati Sudipyo as a formal educational institution. LPPMS goal is to develop human resources in an enterprise through trainings related to both the inner and outer appearance.
Another meaningful line business of PT Mustika Ratu is Putri Indonesia. Putri Indonesia is a pioneer in the field of beauty pageants in Indonesia. The founder has desire to be able to provide opportunities for young people, especially women, to be able to play and contribute directly to our beloved country, not only on a national scale, but also as an ambassador of Indonesia in the international scale. Beside the very noble desire, Putri Indonesia is still in line with the vision of the company to make profit for the sustainability of the company, because Putri Indonesia will also to build and manage its brand image, which affect positively to the sales of Mustika Ratu products.
Miss Indonesia Foundation, in cooperation with the National AIDS Committee, in order to assist the implementation of prevention campaigns in HIV/AIDS.
Runner-up of Miss Indonesia will be given the title of Miss Indonesian Environment, which will serve as an ambassador to help the Ministry of the Environment.
As BNN ambassador, Putri Indonesia participate actively support the anti-drug campaign organized by the National Narcotics Agency.
As an ambassador of the National Commission for Child Protection, Putri Indonesia consistently arrange and involve in care activities for the children of Indonesia.
Being Putri Indonesia as ambassador of the nation in various events at national forums and internationally to introduce Indonesia tourism, culture, economy, and commodity trading Indonesia.
In recent years, Indonesia less favorable aspect of tourism due to the situation and security conditions that are not conducive for foreign tourists to visit Indonesia. It will spur tourism and economic development of other sectors such as hospitality, restaurant, craft industry, fashion, health and beauty products, spa industrial objects, and animate objects other travel.
Putri Indonesia also actively in social activities in bottom pyramid of communities.
The business model of Mustika Ratu involving a lot of sectors, from upstream to downstream. At upstream side, their traditional beauty product and jamu using the natural raw material such as spices and herbs from Indonesia. To fulfill these natural ingredients of raw material, they cooperate with local farmers, which is part of the bottom pyramid. At downstream side, they establish an integrated system of distribution and selling to deliver their product to market. This integrated system cooperate with distribution and retailer sectors, which empowering a lot of manpower resources.
Mustika Ratu has gross profit for the 12 months in September 2014 was $206 million.
Mustika Ratu has a gross margin of 56% for the quarter that ended in September 2014.
The company believes that human resources is one of its main assets in fulfilling product quality demands on its midst of business competition. It has obtained a special appreciation from PT Jamsostek in the form of free medical check-up for all employees above 40 years old for fulfilling the regulation of PT Jamsostek.
The company strives to establish and maximize its corporate governance as an important factor in gaining the trust of shareholders and other stakeholders. By implementing the basic principle of corporate governance, the company believes in the creation of balance in the entire business to include a series of interests from within or outside the company.